That is why you have set this time for us, Lord, that we may receive your blessings. Your intention, Lord, is clear to us since morning. You have ministered to us in diverse ways, and we give you praise. Even as we sit to listen to you, Lord. Lord, this is the bread of life. May you define our lives by your word, and may you make it clear to us. May we understand what you are going to teach us. Father, the task is great for me. I'm only a vessel available to you, and I pray and seek for your help. That I'm going to speak and to minister your very will. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Nashukuru Mungu sana. Imagine the way nilikuwa nasikia baridi hapa asubuhi. I imagined that's how you are all feeling. And now looking at you from this side, you don't look bad even katikati ya baridi. Unajua mtu akiwa kwa baridi najikuja hatimaye kupoteza sura hapa na pale. But you look nice from this side, and I really thank God for you. Wiki yetu imekuaje? Nashukuru Mungu. Sasa mtu asikose kukunywa ukai, ukikunywa maji moto kama uko karibu naye na uvae vizuri. This is not the time kuogopa itaonekana na furana mbili. This week nimeenda town na furana mbili. Japokuwa moja nilikuwa na ficha pale. Sababu sasa hakuna tena kujipiga kifua, hii baridi nayo ni kali. But I will thank God for every season that belongs to him. These are very nice moments the Lord has allowed us that we may hear and listen to the word of God. And I believe, like I am persuaded in my heart, the Lord has aimed to do us good. Hakuna wakati Mungu ameketi na kutupangia vibaya. His aim, his sole intention is to bless us. And I only desire and hope that you are ready to receive the blessings. Are we ready to receive the blessings from God? Now we can go on. I want us to study something very common, very popular, and very simple. Only that because of its simplicity, the world and the devil has made it to be a very complex subject. Na hiyo imefanya watu wengi wengi wachukie kanisa na wachukie Mungu. And I believe now, the very few minutes that I have ahead of me, we are going to do a study. And I just request that you follow each other. And I was feeling to allow us, because of the importance of this topic, I was feeling to allow us, should you feel like ninakupoteza njia, that you are not getting it right, you just raise your hand. Feel free. This is a service of its kind so that you can understand each other. I'm going to teach about the fundamental principles of giving. The fundamental principles of giving. Na nimemali sentence yangu imefikia pale. So sijasema pesa. I've not said the fundamental principles of giving money, no. I am talking about giving. And this is not a giving service. It is just an edifying service. Ambapo tutasoma. What was the intention of God to introduce giving to us? Where did it start in the Bible? Nilikuwa nimefikiria sana. When did I learn first how to give? Nilisoma lini? I was a little child. And that topic came to me in a confused state. And if I was to depend on how I learned that subject when I was young, I all got confused. And I think I'm not alone in this. Wengi tulisoma kutoa tukiwa watoto. Unfortunately, tukiwa watoto, especially kama sisi tumezaliwa tukiwa vijana watano wamefuatana, that was a vocabulary in our dictionary. We didn't know how to give. We knew competition. And we knew how to acquire more to yourself. In that little house we were living, and we are five of us, kama ni avocado zako, you had to hide. You know where to hide in that house. Kwa sababu, your brother is looking at them. Na mimi natafuta zake. Na saa hiyo nimeweka gunia mzima ya avocado. Siwezi maliza. But I cannot give to them. They are not giving to me. I knew how to snatch. And unfortunately, even our parents were never able to teach us giving. Hata ninashukuru sana siku hizi watoto wakienda shuleni. These are the times unasikia mtoto akikuambia, but of course ni wakati wewe uko na kitu. Anakuambia sharing is caring. Sisi hatu kujua hiyo lugha. And I'm happy if you knew it. We never knew how to share. We grew up very selfish and very greedy. Selfish ni kujitakia. You want more. You have an avocado, each one of you, lakini unataka ya mwenzako. Selfishness. And also, we were greedy. Greedy ni kutotosheka. I was thinking of this na lugha yangu ya mama. Na nilikuwa nafikiria, as giving kwa Kikuyu, ni koruta kana niko heana. It's different. Koruta na koheana are different. And today, maybe at the end of the service, you're going to understand the difference. And in your own, I want you to understand it, and I want us to understand it in the simplest way possible. Because when we talk about koheana, I can give anything, mbora it is outside me. I can peana, mbora too it is outside me. It is easy to give you what is not inside of me. But when we talk of kutoa, unatoa wapi? Lazima iwenda? You get the difference. Koheana, you can koheana or kupeana something that it is in the exterior, iko nje. But kutoa, lazima iko ndani. And that's why I am coming the subtitle. That giving is a matter of the heart. Giving is not a matter of the pocket. Giving is not a matter of our bank accounts. It is a matter of the heart. That's why I'm categorizing my giving today as kutoa. Kutoa, kujitolea, kutoa. It is more than giving. Ile ya kuheana, kupeana. You will never give kutoa something that you don't own. You cannot kutoa what you do not own. But you can kupeana what even belongs to other person. Kwa mfano, unaweza kuja kwangu kwa nyumba, saa ile my wife hayuko, by the way my wife is here, unaweza ukawainua watu mikono hivi wakusalimia yeye, pole. Nilikuja nikiwa, ninafikiria sana kuhusu hii topic, sorry, na thank God in the morning, pastor alituambia Mungu akija pale, mtu mwingine asiingie kwa katikati. But it was important for me to introduce her. Sorry for that. If you come into a house when my wife is not there, na useme, ni jirani tu, nataka sufuria, ile ya kuchemsha maji, ama nataka jiko. Hizo vitu, kila kitu naweza fanya, ni kupeana. Sababu hata si zangu, ni za my wife. Lakini kutoa, yeye anaweza kutoa akwambie hamna sufuria tuko na moja tu mko na kuoga na moja peke yake hiyo enda nayo muage mnapika nayo hiyo sasa ametoa hiyo ni kutoa mimi naweza tu peana because it doesn't belong to me. Giving is a matter of the heart. Now let me come to this. Sasa tuulizane wapi basi moyo inashikana na vitu hizi tunatoa physical. Jesus said your heart is where your treasure is. Kila kitu umekidhamini na moyo. Unakidhamini sana, unawekaga kwa moyo. Iwe ni hii guo, iwe ni sufuria, iwe ni pesa. Anything that matters to you, it is in your heart. And that is why you cannot remove your heart from giving, kutoa. So, kila kitu ambacho, it makes sense or it is important to you, you already have a place of it in your heart. Iwe ni gari, iwe ni kazi, iwe ni nini, it is in your heart. And now, let me come closer. Nilisema, giving is a matter of the heart. The third point, God demands that we worship Him with our hearts. God demands that we worship Him with our hearts. Sasa unaona Mungu mahali amefikia. Tuseme ni nguo, ninaipenda sana, it matters so much to me, na nimeitengea mahali in my heart. Then God says, if you want to worship me in truth and spirit. Or I want your heart. That is where now giving becomes part of worship. Giving becomes part of worship because it is in my heart. And now when I'm giving what is in my heart, simply I am worshiping God with my heart. Even if nimetoa just 100 shillings, if that 100 shillings is important to me, it is in my heart. And now when I come to God to give Him that 100, it is 100 plus my heart. And that is worship. So, giving is a matter of the heart, and we worship God with our hearts. So, giving is worship. Na hiyo jina ninasema kutoa, kwa Kiingereza sio sana sana giving, we use the word sacrifice. We use the word sacrifice. Like for example, Sahi, I cannot ask you to sacrifice to me what you don't own. Kama sahi niambie Mrs. Karuri, Mrs. Pastor Karuri, anipatie hiyo, tuseme amenunuliwa karamu, ama sio yake, achukue hiyo ya husband, nimwambie anipe. Anaweza akasema eti ame sacrifice. Na karamu ni ya Pastor Karuri. No, you cannot sacrifice what you do not own. And God wants us to sacrifice or to give to Him what is part of us. I want to prove to us through the scriptures that giving is a matter of the heart, and God asks or demands that we worship Him with our hearts, that is, even with our substances. Genesis chapter 4, the first beginning of the word give or offer. Sasa tukisoma mtakuwa mnaniambia whether that was kupeana or sacrifice. Genesis chapter 4, verse 1. Genesis chapter 4, the story of Cain and Abel. That was the first mention of the word give. Let's read. Genesis 4, nasoma na New King James Version. And Adam knew his wife, and she conceived, and bore Cain, and said, I've gotten a man from the Lord. And she again bore his brother Abel, and Abel was a keeper of sheep, but Cain was a tiller of the ground. And in the process of time, it came to pass that Cain brought of the fruit of the ground an offering unto the Lord. That word offering is other scriptures, versions talk about sacrifice. And Abel, he also brought of the firstlings of his flock and of the fat thereof. I want you now to listen to this verse 4. Verse 4, the Bible says, and the Lord respected Abel and his offering. Let's continue. And the Lord respected Abel and his offering, but he did not respect Cain. I want you to see, to start there. But he did not respect Cain. So let us distinguish between the two. We have the persons, Abel, and we have his offering here. We have Cain and his offering here. God, when he's appreciating Abel, he's not starting with his sacrifice. The Bible is saying God respected who? Abel, period. Then the Bible continues to add a conjunction that and his offering. Mungu akanikubali na akakubali sadaka yangu. What about Cain? Cain was not respected, but he did not respect Cain. Period. And his offering. So offering na Cain mwenyewe ziko kando ama wako kando. Abel na sadaka yake iko kando. So I take it from this scripture that giving is not so much of the type of what you want to give. Giving before God is not so much of the type of the offering. It's not the type, because the Bible has not indicated Mungu alichukia boga. Wajua mimi nilimewahi kusikia pastor akisema, imagine cabbage. Watu wagapi wanajua cabbage? Tunainua mikono. Wagapi wanajua kitunguu? Wagapi wanajua spinach? Wagapi wanajua biriganya? Akasema, imagine Cain alileta hizo biriganya, pilipili hoho na cabbage, akizichoma, hata wewe unaweza kaa hapa kwa hiyo moshi. And that is why God had to kuangalia kwingine. The Bible, the Holy Spirit has not found it important to tell us how God felt of the type of the offering, because that is not so important. What is important are the two nouns, Cain and Abel. And in simple terms, it is what is in their hearts. Because the Bible says, as a man thinketh, so is he. So God rejected the heart, the attitude of Cain. New Testament says that the reason why God rejected Cain's sacrifice or offering, it is because he had harbored bitterness in his heart. So hata kabla waenda kutoa sadaka, the heart of Cain was negative. So it is not so much boga. Ama sasa eti walafu walikuwa nasema nyama choma. Unaona nyama choma ikichoma, si hata unataka kunusia. That was not the case. That was not the issue. The issue is not the type of the offering. The issue is the state of your heart. Now let me go back. Dio to see how. Even if I'm not going to talk so many things, please never forget this. That giving is a matter of the heart. Number two, anything that you value, you keep it in your heart. Number three, God demands that we worship Him with our... Please get that. So, ukiona Mungu anakataa sadaka ya Cain, ni moyo yake vile imekaa, Mungu amekataa. Ukiona Mungu amekubali Abel, ni moyo yake vile imekaa. And now God was now to receive that sacrifice. John chapter 4 verse 23. Because I would want to really insist on that. John chapter 4 verse 23, the New Testament. Alafu tutarudi Genesis bado, so tutarudi that is Exodus. John chapter 4 verse 23. The Bible says this. Bwana Yesu amepatwa na, yeah, Jesus amepatwa na the Samaritan woman. The Samaritan woman has come and met Jesus at the well. Nakumbuka the conversation? Give me water. The lady says, no, sisi hatu, na nyinyi hatushirikiani. These are the words of Jesus. Because the lady pushed Jesus so much theologically. Kana kwamba she want to challenge Jesus' theology. But Jesus says, but the hour is coming. And now is. So since that time, ulikuwa naongea, the hour had come to do what? When the true worshippers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father is seeking such to worship Him. So that is why I'm insisting that God will never, never, never stop to look into your heart anytime you are giving. Because He's so much interested with your heart. Wakati Mungu aliangalia tu sadaka ya Cain na Abel, ghafla, aliona moyo yao kwanza, because God is a spirit. Lakini zile vitu Cain alikuwa ameleta ni physical. God is a spirit. Na zile sadaka Abel alikuwa ameleta ni physical. And God being a spirit, akiangalia kwanza anaona moyo. Na anaona moyo kabla hata a consider what is there. And so the heart of Cain was wrong. The heart of Abel was right. Because God is a spirit, is demanding that we worship Him with our spirit. So in a moment, therefore, you exclude your heart from giving, you are not worshiping the living God. In a moment, you exclude your heart from giving, you are not worshiping the Lord. So I want us to take care of the heart now. Simeona moyo vile inahusika. Now let me come close. I want us to learn now how to protect your heart so that every moment you take to God an offering, the Lord will be looking at your heart na anaona iko sawa. I heard the scripture in Exodus chapter 4. Exodus chapter 10, sorry. Exodus chapter 10 verse 26. Because of time, let me talk about it, but it is Exodus 10:26. The Bible talks of the children of Israel. Musa anamwambia Firauni, Mungu anasema uachilie hawa watoto waende. Firauni amesukumwa na sign ya kwanza, sign ya pili, sign ya tatu, and Pharaoh continues to harden his heart. The Bible says, now Firauni moyo yake ikayayuka kidogo, akasema hivi, you can go, you go to the desert. Musa, unataka kwanza kwenda, nendeni nyinyi na watoto wenu. But verse 25 kidogo. Yeah, but Moses said, Firauni anawaambia, mtaweza kwenda nyinyi na watoto wenu, lakini kondoo zenu na ngombe zenu msibebe. Na hajui Musa, Mungu wa Musa, ni Mungu wa sadaka na anataka kuabudiwa na sadaka. But Moses said, you must also give us sacrifices and burnt offerings that we may sacrifice to the Lord, our God. Tuendelee hiyo ingine. Our livestock also shall go with us. Not a hoof shall be left behind. For we must take some of them to serve the Lord. You see that word serve? It is, maybe your Bible talks about worship. They are used interchangeably. Serving God and worshiping God, they are used as synonymous. Zinafanana. Kwa hivyo Musa anasema, hatutawacha kondoo zetu na hatutawacha ngombe zetu, because God demands that we worship Him with them. Why? Because if they left this livestock, kwanza wamwachie Firauni, na vile wanapenda, sababu wao ni wafugaji, ni kama tu wale ndugu zetu wa Maasai, ama wale watu wengine wanaweka ngombe na wanaweka kabuzi, wanazipenda sana sana. So ukiwaambia wakuamwabudu Mungu bila hizo ngombe, bila kujitolea, bila kumtolea Mungu gobe zao, basi unawanyima nafasi ya kuabudu Mungu kwa mioyo yao, because ngombe zao ziko kwa mioyo yao. It is coming from their hearts. God is so much interested with the condition of your heart, the time you are giving. Na nikasema kutoa sio kupeana, siongei sana maana kuhusu kupeana, ni kutoa, because kutoa lazima inatoka kwa moyo. And then Mungu sasa akaona mwanadamu, the state of the heart of man. God has started from Genesis to analyze the heart of a man. Jeremiah anasema, I think chapter 17, anasema, this is God talking, the heart of man is deceitful than anything else. It is God. From Genesis, Mungu ameanza kusema, na moyo ya mwanadamu, it is very evil. Unajua wewe huwezi ona moyo yangu? Mimi, I can't see your heart. But God sees it too. And He's the one who can give us a conclusion of how your heart is. And so, Jeremiah is saying that God, the heart of a man is deceitful. So, God, hata tukisema tutoe hapa, He's the only one who is able to tell whether wewe ni kupeana tu umepeana something that belongs to you, or umetoa. Umetoa. So God, because of the mistake and the sin Adam did, and the generations that followed, the heart of man continued being corrupt in these two main sins. Man grew very selfish, and man grew very greedy. From Genesis, kuja tu hivi, unaona Kaini anaua brother yake kwa nini? He's just selfish. Bona na mimi nisifurahishe Mungu? Kwa nini hakukubali yangu? Selfishness and greed. And I'm telling us that when Jesus came and He started to preach about the kingdom of God and the qualifications, na akaanza kusema ukifanya hii hautaingia, ukifanya hii hautaingia, Jesus mentioned several sins. And I want us to know today, the number one sin on the top list, ile Yesu alisema. That's why this topic is critically important. And the devil knows that. That's why I may distort sana. The number one sin, Jesus rebuked adultery. Jesus rebuked vitu mingi. He rebuked legalism. He rebuked many things. But Jesus so much rebuked the sin of hypocrisy. Hypocrisy is when you are portraying to us what you are not in your heart. Then He rebuked greed. Top there. Gukoroka. Or covetousness. Covetousness is wanting more than what you already have enough of. unataka zaidi na zaidi na zaidi. I was thinking in my mother tongue, what is the meaning of the word koigania? Koigania. Mato, what is koigania? Na kizungu sasa tunaweza ita nini? Contentment. Sasa nataka wale wa Kikuyu sasa wale wa ndani. Sababu hawa ni wa Kikuyu wetu na ni wazuri. Sababu kuna tofauti ya koigania na koiganira. So what I've asked, koigania na koiganira. When the Bible talks of greed, is wanting more than what you already have enough of. Or what is enough? Enough is enough, that you say so. There is a difference between enough and contentment. Contentment and enough are different. And the heart of man, I say today, will never have enough. But the heart of man, if trained, can be contented. My boy, sorry for using this example, I mean this as a very ugly kid. My son loves, and his number one delicacy on the top list, hapendi nyama, hata akija kwako usimpe nyama, napenda madazi. Maina loves madazi sana. So asubuhi akienda shule, anakaa pale akawekewa madazi kwa sahani. Akakula sijui ilikuwa ngapi. So mimi nilisikia tu ameniita. Na mimi nilikuwa najitayarisha niende nyumbani, niende kazi. So nikaja akaniambia, "Daddy, kuna kitu kimoja nataka kukuuliza." Akauliza na kizungu. "Who came with aliulizaje hivi? Nani alikuja na hii jina kutosheka?" Nikamuliza, "Bona unauliza hivyo?" Hasemi ni kwa nini, lakini alikuwa ameanza kukula anakiwa hivi, sasa ako hivi na kuna madazi zingine kwa sahani. So he's asking, "Nani alikuja na hii jina kutosheka?" Nikamwambia ni majina tu kama mengine. Akaniambia, "Sasa hii madazi niongezewe kwa ile nitabeba." Ameshiba, lakini he's wondering, ataiwacha kwa sahani. So there's a difference between koigania and koiganira. And God looks into your heart and my heart. Wakati unamuomba kitu ingine, are you seeking him from the point of koigania? You want more and more and more. Or you want something to make you satisfied. I was looking at the dictionary meaning of that content, contentment. It is that state of satisfaction of one's heart that makes you happy. That makes you happy. And Jesus, when he was talking about and teaching about giving, remember he's addressing the number two sins ambazo zimeadhiri mwanadamu tangu Genesis: hypocrisy and greed. And I want to tell you that when I checked from the online Bible the grievousness of this word greed, I met that it is like mentioned over 14 times alongside idolatry, alongside adultery, alongside other sins. Even the book of Revelation says those people that will be left back behind, watatupwa jehanamu. Greed has a large portion. Just imagine. Because greed, you want more. And it is out of greed, someone, sababu sahi, let me tell us something very funny. We can be gifted by someone 1,000 shillings. Wewe upewe 1,000 na mimi nipewe 1,000. But when it comes to our hearts, it has different value. And to some of us, we will koiganera. To some of us, tutinaigania. And that is why with that 1,000, nitaenda niangalie wale watu wanafanya betting. Because nimepata dhao, naweza fanya betting so that I can win another 100,000. Na unawekelea maisha yote. But wengine wakutosheka. Maybe, sisemi investment ni baya, because I'm coming to that. I'm talking about the state of your heart. And you're like, "Oh God, I'm very thankful. I am very thankful that you have given me this. And now, help me." This introduces us to something I'm going to talk about shortly. help me to know how best this money I can do with it. Number one thing is that I know it has come from you, so I acknowledge you. And that is where tithing comes in, or giving to God. Kutoa sasa, unatoa kwa moyo, and you tithe. And let me not preempt. I'm going to talk about that in the next stage. But meanwhile, what I'm saying is that some of our hearts get contented, and some of us remains greedy. And so even as you see that kwenye matatu ama kwa barabara mko wengi mkienda kazi, some of those people are going there because wanataka more and more and more, never to have enough. Others are going there because already their hearts are content that God has already blessed me. That's what you are being reminded in the morning. I am blessed, and so I'm going to town to find something that God has kept for me. It is a state of your heart. And God is so much interested with your heart. In a moment, you are thinking of giving. There is this verse I want us to read together. Hii hata tusipowekewa pale tutasema. John chapter 3 verse 16. John 3:16. We know it. Because there is an aspect of giving we fight there. The Bible says, for God so loved the world. Hii tunaweza saidiana wale tunaona pale. For God, that, yes, so that whoever should not perish but have everlasting life. I want you to go back in there and underline the word only. Only. That word only gives that verse a whole meaning altogether. Haya, let me now, let me do it practically. I want to ask Mama Grace, Mom Grace, kama unaweza kuwa na kalamu ingine, unaweza nipa. Uko na ingine? So she has two. Unaona amenipa hii? Haya, sasa nitamuuliza. Na bona ulikuwa unatumia hii na uko na ingine? Siko na ingine? Kwa nini akachagua hii? Na hii bado itafanya. It's also a nice phone, a nice pen. Why are you using it? Haya, preference. This, I want us to get something here. God has gifted her with two pens, eh? But she has made a position in her heart for these two pens. Hizi karamu zote mbili ziko kwa moyo wake, but at different values. And that is why when she was opting for what to use, alichagua hii. Meaning hii haina position moja na ile. And so, if nimuombe hii karamu, niwe naandika nayo kutoka leo iwe ni yangu, she can say, or we can conclude this, applying that verse, or that word, only. She has given me her only pen. It does not mean hana ingine. The place in her heart this pen occupied was special. And so when she was giving it to me, it was the only of its kind. But to God, giving his only begotten son, he didn't have anyone else of that kind. So to us, because God is not asking us for our sons, he's asking me for something that is in my heart, but it's not just anything. For example, now, if Mom Grace was told by God, give me your favorite pen, agetoa ile, Mungu ageona, she has not done honest. Because this was her only of its kind. There is a special value that you have given to this pen. That's why you are using it now. Hata kwa nguo. Wagapi waliwacha agarau nguo ingine moja kwa wardrobe. Fine, bona ulivaa hii leo. It has a special attachment to you. And so when God maybe would tell you to give out your dress, and you go for that other one and you revere mara ya mwisho January, God knows you have not given him. You are honoring. Because your honoring means specification. Una kitu ya sombi wanaita the scandal of particularity. God, katikati ya vitu nyingi anachagua. Kama ni Abraham, kuna watu wengi wamezaliwa, but he chooses Abraham. One person. Kama ni Musa, kuna wahibirania wengi, but God chooses Moses. Why? Na watu wote ni wa Mungu. God is particular and specific. So this pen has a special attachment to her. So I'm talking about the heart, the state of your heart. Because when you are giving, God checks in your heart. Let me now go to something else. Paul says in Philippians chapter 3, 16, 17, he talks about something yenye tumesema hapa inaitwa contentment. Kabla hiyo, that is Philippians 4:12. Let me go back to the first one, the first statement. Ile tulikuwa tunasoma, giving is a matter of the heart. I forgot to read, to talk about Exodus 25, verse 1, 2, 3. God tells Moses, "Moses, I want to have somewhere people will be coming to worship me." Fine. Na itagharimu vitu nyingi. Itagharimu gold, itagharimu silver, itagharimu vitu of different value. And so, God, in his sovereignty, wants people to participate. It is a sanctuary for the people to worship God. God cannot worship himself. And so he wants people to worship him. But remember the condition that people, whenever you want to worship God, you must involve your John 4, usually is how that God demands that those who want to worship him must worship him in truth and spirit. And so God wants people to make somewhere or to something to be constructed, Mungu atakuwa na abudiwa. And God, na his number one focus, akikubuka mwanadamu, is the heart. This is what God says. Because I don't want people to be coming to worship me without their hearts. Wasiwache moyo nje. So this is the description of the type of people. The condition of their hearts, God demands. Speak to the children of Israel, that they may bring me an offering from everyone who gives it willingly with his heart, you shall take my offering. Let's go on the flip side. Hiyo verse tu venye iko, we go on the flip side. What about the purification? Sababu kuna watu Mungu amechuja hivyo, si ndio? Jana nimesikia sijui nimuite mhubiri. Nilisikia mtu anaongea maneno ako na kanisa, anaongoza kanisa. And he had this microphone. Akasema sasa, hapa nikiitisha pesa, msilete eti mashiriki hapa na mangotore. Sema, na mangotore. Kama hizo lizo utatoa, toka kwa kanisa yangu. Jana, iko kwa internet. He's giving, anachuja watu kadhaa. Wale ambao wanafaa kuwa kwa hiyo. Na kala sema hapa watu wale tunafanya kazi na wao. Wana earn 500,000. Ananiuliza, umetupata ngapi 500,000? Sawa wewe kuja. 1,300, sawa. Na kanisa imejaa. Na wateka sema, amen. For God to give such a specific description from everyone who gives it willingly. Number one thing is willingness. Hallelujah. Na diyo nikasema staki kuhubiri kuhusu kuheana, apana, ni kutoa. Because will is an aspect of the heart. It's a concept of the heart. Let me use my wife as an example. Kuna siku fulani, ilikuwa, akaniambia, hata kama atukakubaliana nataka ni vizuri niwe nampatia pesa ya nywele. Agaro anasikia nina participate. So akaniambia siku moja, na hii nywele inahitaji kutengenezwa. Anambia, "Oh, time is up." Nilinyamaza. Na hiyo that was my habit. Nikiambiwa ninanyamaza. Sasa ndani yangu nilikuwa nasema, "Wah, okay, another bill." So ninaipangia. So mimi simwambi that nimeanza kuipangia. So I was keeping quiet. So tunakaa siku mbili tatu, ulisemaje kuhusu nywele? Nipe siku moja. Kama nipe siku mbili. And then one day, I don't know what you are talking about. And she told me, "Do you know you have never given me pesa ya kusukwa?" Nikasema, "Either sijusikia vizuri, or there is a problem in this house." Because the very fresh memory is, every month, lazima nipeane pesa. Na sasa tuko miaka isijui ilikuwa miaka saba. Na nasema sijawahi mpea pesa. So nikasema hapa, there is something wrong with memory lapse. And I sat down nikamwambia, "Please, now So siku, this time sikuzusha. Sema hapana, nibu nieleze, what exactly do you mean? Because you and I know, every month ninakupa pesa. Kasema kuligana mimi, according to me, you have never given. Sema, okay, now explain to me. This is what she told me. Every moment nikikuitisha pesa ya nywele, every time you keep quiet. So you leave me guessing whether unataka ama hutaki. It is until siku tatu, nitakuliza masiku mbili, that's when you say, now you fix the date. This is the date enye nitakupa, after nimekukubusha. And so according to me as a woman, you have never given me money. So nowadays I think I changed. Yes, but I think I changed. Kiniambia, ata kama hauna ile cash, ama haujapanga vizuri, unajua some of these needs, hiyo tutaongea na wana youth, wacha nisisemee hapa. Some of these things usifikiria eti itawekwa kwa budget, ati anakumbuka ni siku gani ndio akwambia mambo ya nywele. Hapana. Kuna kitu kwa nywele inaitagwa growth. Na wakisikia growth, it is time kutengenezwa. Whether ni katikati ya mwezi. My heart never demonstrated willingness. And she said, you have never given me money. So irrespective of the quantity of money, waga nampea, it mattered nothing. And to her, it was never giving. And to her, it was not love. What about God? In a moment, I don't involve my will when I'm giving. My heart is there, fine. Ninampatia kitu inatoka kwa moyo, fine. But now another aspect. If I am not willing, God will never receive that thing. That's why he's very, very specific. And I'm going to enter into the next stage, niseme hivi. When God is looking at the state of your heart, he checks on the attitude. Are you willing? Or you are grappling inside? Willing with his heart, you shall take my offering. So if Moses had the capacity to kupima, ajue umepiga kerere pale ukireta, ana atasema, wewe Mungu yu hataki. We have a brother, our brother Mokolino, we love him. Tuna fellowship sana. And that brother alituambia siku moja, sababu we really discussed the Bible together. Akasema, we have our a family at home. Kwao ni Nyadarwa. We have a family at home. Na hiyo family, wanga wazee wakienda kutembea kule, you make ugali for them. Or you cook for them. So, our brother tells us, his faith, our brother tells us, that siku moja, familia frani wametegeneza ugali. And so wazee wa kanisa wanajipanga dio waende. Wakitoka church waende. Akatuwabia na Kikuyu, gaya ugiregi meyo dekareyo tone manu una. So Mungu aliongea tu wakiwa kwa church kwa upitia nabii. Hey! Na hiyo ugali mtu yote asikule, sababu wale wamepiga kelele in their hearts. Na wakukula, imagine. Ugali ya wazee wote ilikuwa imepikwa ya wazee wa church. Waliwachiwa hapo. Roho alisema isikuliwe. Siwa menogona. What do you imagine about our God? He checks on your heart. Na nirudi hapa. The type or the quantity of your offering does not matter to God. What matters is the state of your heart. So willingness is key. And this is repeated by Apostle Paul in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 8. He says, whenever we are coming to give to God, your heart actually should be cheerful. You should be willing. You should be willing to give. Now, let me talk about this second principle, about contentment. Philippians chapter 4 verse 12, the Bible says, Philippians chapter 4 verse 12, nilisema, I will concentrate so much in making our hearts something that the Lord will accept even before we give the offering. I know how to be abased. Go to the previous verse 11, please. Not that I speak in regard to need, for I have learned in whatever state I am to be content. Because I wanted us to concentrate on the wordings. I have learned to be content, whether I have much or I have little. Let me not paraphrase. Let me read. Verse 11. Not that I complain of want Okay, verse 10. Ebu tuede verse 10. Kidogo tu. Verse 10. Philippians 4:10. I rejoice in the Lord greatly that now at length you have revived your concern for me. Or in other words, you are now willing. You are willing to help me. But you had no opportunity. You were willing. Imagine, Paul anashukuru Mungu, hawajampa, but their hearts were already willing to give him. Hata kabla apoke, he's saying, I greatly rejoice in the Lord. And then the Bible says that, not that I complain of want, for I have learned in whatever state I am to be content. I know how to be abased. I know how to abound. And in any and all circumstances, I have learned the secret of facing plenty and hunger, abundance and want. Brethren, and the very, very popular verse goes there, verse 13. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. That verse, tukiulizwa tuseme ni mambo gapi unaweza ukafanya because Christ strengthens you, tutasema kufufua, which is good. Tutasema healing. I can move mountains, fine. But the context within which that word was written is that you're able to survive with what God has given you. You can do all things. You're able to live within your means. Now, let's go back to that, the previous verse. The Bible says, I have learned this matter tunaogea hapa about being contented. It is something that you can only learn. It's only God who can teach you how to be content. How to be content. Moyo yako sio kuigania apana. Hata pesa hatujaigania hajakuwa enough. But at least we can have joy in the Lord that God has given us something. That this fire have come, the Lord has done it for me. This week to cure in our home cell, the preacher of the day alituambia kitu ambayo ilipeleka mbali sana because I was conscious of this sermon today. Akatuambia, katukubusha, in the book of Acts, Peter and John, the disciples of Jesus has left, they are full of the Holy Spirit and they are going to pray in the temple. And there they met the crippled man at the gate. And the crippled man sought for gold. Please nipe kitu. Peter was very, very clear. And he singled himself out. Kasama, mimi. I do not have silver or gold. I. Sijui John, but I. He talked about, it was not we, it was I. I don't have silver or gold. But what I have, I am going to give to you. In the name of Jesus Christ, rise and walk. So imagine, after shida, sijui kama ni shetani, ama ni shida, ama ni hali. After hali iliodorea Petro silver zote, hali zikaodorea Petro gold zote, he had still some value in his heart because he had Jesus and his name. And so, the help this man wanted was still provided in whatever way. That is why now, Peter is the best person to quote that I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Silver and gold I don't have, but at least I have something. And this is what God always looks in you. God may not demand that you give him the gold that you don't have. God will never demand from you silver that you don't have. But at least in your heart, there should be something. And this is God. And this is what you have been talking about. Your heart should never empty God. Hata ukikosa vitu zingine. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. I'm going now to go into the second phase. Nikimalizia. We have talked about contentment. Something that you can learn. Something that you can learn. To be content. Before these other things come by. You can be content. Without fearing of tomorrow. Because you have trusted God. Na umeenda kazi. And this is what he has given you. God will always put something in your hands. This is what he has given you. So even as you desire to have more, but that day, imeisha, then this is what you have. Are you able to be content with God and you'll be satisfied and you thank God for that day? We are going to learn about what I have discussed already We have three laws of giving ahead prepared, and the first one is niyo tumeongea, the law of sufficiency. The three laws of giving, it is the law of sufficiency. That from that state of thankfulness, that God, in the evening, I wanted to have 10,000, but I already have one. And Lord, I come to you to thank you. And number one thing you do is you acknowledge God, you are the one who has given this to me. Do you know what happens? Very fast, let me give this example. When you have 1,000 shillings, ukiwa na dhao moja, uigie kwa supermarket, sikuna ile kiwango ya vitu naweza toka nazo kule. So meaning, it is that 1,000 value is your power. When you're going to that supermarket, that is the power. So you have the power equal to 1,000, and you're able to get some things from that supermarket. So 1,000 is your power. So who has given you by evening? Sota tulieda kazi, na by jioni umepata 1,000. Who has given you that power, that money? It is God, okay? So number one thing you do, if you are contented, is to acknowledge God's power. Sio tu kwa mdomo, but you do something else. You acknowledge God's power. According to Romans chapter 1, sita fungua pale. Romans chapter 1, verse pale 19 ikishuka chini. This is the place. I'm going to give a very odd or awkward example, but it is so, because I found it very important. Romans chapter 1 pale chini, the Bible says of the genesis of how watu wanaabudu sanamu and the lesbians and the homosexuals. Paul has said where that thing starts. Now akasema hii kitu, very very critical. Akasema those people, though what makes God known is plain to them, for example power and deity, though it is plain to everybody. If ata mlevi akitaka kujua kama Mungu wako, Paul is saying it is plain. Though it is plain, those people never acknowledged God or gave him thanks. That is Romans chapter 1. They never acknowledged God or gave him thanks. What happened as a result? God gave them over to their desires. He gave them over. And that is where lesbianism and idolatry sana sana inazaliwa pale. It is when your mind inafikiria very opposite. Because what makes God known is plain, but you choose deliberately to ignore. So now let's go back. Tumeomba Mungu asubuhi, tumeenda kazi, wewe umepata 2,000, mimi nimepata 1,000. That is the power we have. The power of that money that can help you to do something equal to that power. Right? Number one thing you do is to acknowledge that God, this power, this 1,000 power, this 2,000, this 10,000, this power, it has come from you. If you fail to do that, that's where we mess up everything. The law of sufficiency. Now, the other portion, the other law I wanted to talk about, because I want to introduce something, is the law of management. I had prepared three: the law of sufficiency, the law of management, and the law of abundance. I will not talk about abundance. I'm only going to give the quotations. Now, ile 1,000 imetupata. Now the heart is okay. See, we have discussed about the state of the heart. The heart is okay. You are not greedy. The heart is okay. By evening, I have 1,000. Where ukona? 3,000. Where ukona? 5,000. Now, the first thing we do when that money is in our hands is to acknowledge that power, that strength, it comes from God. God gave a warning to the children of Israel. Mtakapotoka kule Misri, and you go through the desert, and you go into the promised land, flowing with milk and honey, never forget it is the Lord who gave you that power to prosper. So how do we acknowledge that God, this has come from you, and how we have put the 1,000 in our hearts? So God demands in the evening that we worship him with that power, with that state of our heart, with that strength. God now asks the principle that was said from Genesis. Abraham amefuata adui na amewachukua na amechukua vitu, amechukua mali nyingi. He acknowledged because he had only 300 people. Now he was slaves. And he has overcome kings when walikuwa amechukua lot. And then he has also plundered. Amechukua mali zao. And now here he comes with mali nyingi sana. Abraham, a man of faith. The number one thing he did is what we are talking about. He knew the strength to overcome has come from God. And so I have too many cattle, I have too many sheep, I have too many goats. Zenye nimechukua kule. Huu ni utajiri wangu. Number one thing, I acknowledge God. How will he do it? Because he wants to worship. The Bible says, akapatana na jamaa. Mwenye Biblia inasema hakuwa na beginning or the end. Anaitwa Melchizedek. And I'm going to rush very fast because this topic of tithing, imagine it has just, it is so plain. Imegharimu mtu fulani ameigiwa na pepo kutu confuse. It is very plain in the scriptures. So Abraham comes back with this plunder, with this spoil. And amepatana na Melchizedek. And he has noted, this is someone very divine. Actually, Hebrews tells us it is Jesus. So as plain as it is, just know it. Hebrews chapter 7, it tells us, this is New Testament now. Melchizedek was Christ. Wakati Kristo alikuwa anajifunua in the Old Testament, it's not a Christophanies. That was Jesus. So Abraham senses this is God. And immediately he acknowledged this power, ya kupata hii mali, it has come from God. And so what he does? He gets 10% of that plunder. Remember, when he was going after those kings, he did not have that money. I mean, that utajiri. Sidio, it is like myself. When I was waking up to go to work, I didn't have that extra 2,000. I didn't have. I only had faith in God. Like Abraham, my father of faith, had faith in God. And so here he comes back with this wealth. He acknowledged God. And in his worship, he got 10%. It was an acknowledgement note. This strength has come from God. And he gave tithe, 10% of that to God, to Melchizedek. Where Melchizedek took, we don't know. Because he didn't have a home, he didn't have father or mother, we don't know. He gave a tithe. This is long before the law. Hey, sheria haikuwa imekuja. So mtu yote asikwambie tithing ni sheria. The law had not come. The law will come 400 years later. And Abraham, as he obeyed God, pastor alikuwa anatuliza asubuhi. Mungu amemwambia Abraham, yule atakubariki nitambariki. Whoever will curse you, I'll curse. Whoever will bless you, I'll bless. And so he asked us. We so much personalize that promise. Sidio. Now, why do we also leave out those other things that follow there? So Jesus, if he was removing or fulfilling the law, he fulfilled the law of Moses. If he was doing away with the precepts of men, traditions of men, he did those that began from Moses' time to Malachi. But what happened to Abraham? Jesus never removed. Because he said in his lifetime, before Abraham was, I am. So whatever is happening to Abraham, Jesus is there. And so get this point. When now the tithing is being introduced to the children of Israel, it is introduced as a law because the heart of man already again has fallen, gone back to selfishness and greed. And so God demands that you tithe and aikadiko ikiwa sheria. And now, get this. The New Testament being promised in the book of Ezekiel and in the book of Jeremiah, the prophet spoke of what shall come. Nakasema, in those days, I will write my laws in your hearts. Which law? The laws of God. And Abraham obeyed God by giving that 10% in acknowledgement of God. Let me now rush. Jesus talked about tithing. And this is what he said. Your leaders, the Pharisees and the scribes, when they are coming to give, they are very strict. Wanahesabu kila kitu, na ya kitu ya kumi wanasema hiyo ni ya Mungu. Kitu ya kumi hiyo ni ya Mungu. Akasema, but they have neglected the very important things, justice and mercy. Na akasema hivi, they could do the first, that is considering justice and mercy, without forgetting the other. Wagefanya ile ya kwanza, Na wasisahau hii ya pili. I'm talking about management. You have your 2,000, I have my 1,000. So number one thing is to acknowledge God. And by that, we thank him. Number two, we give him portion of that money. Let me make this statement very clear. My time is over. God, by asking us to tithe, he does not need any shigo shilling from us. Nobody here can give to God anything. After all, whatever we are and whatever we have has come from him. Anasema hata akipata jaha hezi tuambia. Manake ngobe ziko kwa mirima 1,000 hills. Nizaki. So akipata jaha tatuambia. And so, God, Jesus is saying, these people, wanafanyaga vizuri kuhesabu tithe. But now, they are doing it to acknowledge God. But they should not forget the people when you are around. And that is the concept of, unakumbuka Jesus giving the story about the rich man and Lazarus. The rich man, alikuwa nakula vizuri. Lazarus alikuwa pale wakiwa ni maskini. The Bible do not tell us. Jesus never said, zile dhabi the rich man did so that he can go to hell. Neither did Jesus tell us what good thing Lazarus did so that he can go to heaven. Jesus remained silent. And where the Bible is silent, we remain silent. But Jesus is showing us now, those people wakiwa kwenye ile ngabo ingine, the rich man anasubuka, but Lazarus ako heaven, ako kwenye the bosom of Abraham. The question now comes, Jesus anashikanishaje tajiri mwenye alikuwa na kura akiwa anaangaliwa na Lazarus, anashikanishaje? Na we can only suspect the sin yenye tumesema hapa of selfishness and greed. Hizo mimi I suspect are the ones who took that man to hell. Because Jesus is saying, watu wenu wanafanya vizuri kuleta tithe kwa Mungu, because they acknowledge ni Mungu amewapatia, hizo dhafai, sababu ni mbaka terere na dhafai, but also wasisahau na their Lazarus. And they are mentioned today here, God has given to each one of us a Lazarus around. Na usijione tiwe hauna kazi, there is a Lazarus. Do you know, kwa dunia hii, lazima kuna mtu anavaa guwe saizi yako. Do you know, we hukuragi dengo, na hukuragi nini, lakini unapeda miji. Do you know, in this world, kuna mtu anapeda miji kama wewe, lakini hana. Ule mwingine anavaa guwe saizi yako, Mungu, God makes sure there is a Lazarus around. So as we acknowledge God in tithing, if our hearts are okay, in managing the 1,000, remember a Lazarus. In management, this is what I say. God do not demand us to tithe because he need any money. He does not need any money from us. I can tell you. This is what God wants. Tithing and giving is God's program. Like one servant said, this one is a God's program to train his children. Management. And in the book of Luke, it's time when inafanya nisifanya nisiende kule sana. Luke chapter 11 to chapter 16, Jesus talked about management so much that when now I have the 1,000, ukona ile, how do you manage? Jesus talked about management in depth. Akapeana parables. That's where he was saying, a certain master, mwenye alikuwa tajiri, he went to a far country. Na akawachia mtu fulani. Sasa huyo mtu fulani aliwachiwa ni sisi, ni mimi na wewe. Hizo vitu zote ziliachi. But Yesu was talking about that rich man going and leaving his wealth to his servants. Those servants are you and me, and it is the things that you have. Now, whatever is in your hand, that is what the master has given to you as a trust, as stewardship, so that he can see what you're going to do with it. And I was checking in those parables. Uende usome ukiweza. Luke chapter 11 to 16. The Bible talks of how these servants, when you were watching, managers, how they responded or they reacted with what they were left with. Some, waliwacho wakichapa wale wafanya kazi wengine. Wengine, they appropriated well. But Jesus so much talked on the negative because he knows the heart of man. We really know how to manage what God has given us. So it's a training. It's a training that God takes you and me when he's telling you to tithe, he's training you how to manage. Because number one thing I want to remind us is that God hates wastage. God hates wastage. He hates wastage so much. The Bible, in the book of Matthew chapter 6 verse 40, the Bible talks of unakumbuka Bwana Yesu akipeana mikate, feeding of the 5,000. Jesus is teaching us management, and this is what happened. The number one thing that happened is that, okay, let me first of all say, these are the things that happen to you when you tithe, when you give portion of your money or whatever God has given, whether it is clothing, whatever you give, this is what happens. Number one, you become accountable. Wewe unaweza achiwa mali sasa. You become accountable. Number two, you, what happens to you, you become honest. Do you know me? I don't know how much you earned yesterday. You don't know how much I earned yesterday. And the only person who knows what I have is God. And so when I start calculating my tithe, it is between me and God. And if I can do something right between me and God, that is honesty. Number three, you become faithful. You become faithful. That you can be trusted with something and you become faithful. Number four, you become trustworthy. Now God can trust you with something else. You become trustworthy. And the last thing is that you develop discipline. You know, hivyo kuketi chini na kuhesabu, especially wale watu wa biashara vile tunahesabu. Najua watu wa salary, sana sana you may not have this much problem. But watu wa biashara, ile pesa umepata jana, siyo ya leo na siyo ya siku ingine. So imagine kukaa chini, calculate the profit. We do it between us and God. When you do it right, you become honest and you develop honesty and discipline. Unapata. So this is what happened. Wakati Bwana Yesu ameambia watu sasa, ameambia wanafunzi, give them food. Kasemekana hatuna chakula. So Jesus asked for what was there, the fish and the bread. Akaitana. This is what happened. Jesus, the Bible says, he looked unto heaven. Matthew 6:17. Yeah, it is Matthew chapter 6 verse 40. The number one thing that Jesus, akati alipokea hizo mikate hivi, na fish, the Bible says he looked up and he thanked God. Ile tulisema, you acknowledge God, the source. In actual fact, the word father, it is the same as the word source. The origin. Father, this has come from you. Number one thing Jesus did, he looked unto heaven, he thanked God. Then what he did next, he told the people, or the disciples, to make the people to sit in groups of 50 and 100. That one, as a manager, is called administration. Jesus is teaching us management. He wants his children to learn management. So number one, you acknowledge God, the owner of the resource. Then administration, sit in groups of 50 and 100. Then number three, he gave to the disciples. Then the disciples distributed to the people. That is delegation. As a good manager, you should learn how to delegate. And then Jesus told this to the disciples. After watu wamekula na wameshiba, wamehakikishwa wameshiba, Jesus said something very unique. He said, go and collect every leftover. Go and collect every leftover. Because he said we should not have any wastage. What? Now, I'm going to ask us today. Do you think Jesus wanted the disciples to go and eat the leftovers? What was the reason? Bwana Yesu alisema hizo mabaki za chakula. Kama zile tu zako zinamwagika kwa meza hapo. Unafikiria ni kwa nini? Tufikirie pamoja. Bwana Yesu alisema hizo mabaki zirokotwe zote. Na wakarokota 12 baskets. Hakukuwa na gurue wanaenda kufeed. Jesus hawakuwa wanapenda gurue. Ama tukuku kama tule twangu. Hapana. Where did they take, or what was the reason? Alisema wachukue. Jesus didn't have so much need or use na those crumbs or leftovers. He wanted his children to learn that God hates wastage. If God entrusts you with something, please take care of it. So number one, acknowledge God. That's a good manager. And then he got the bread, the resources. He delegated, then the distribution. Now, to make my final comment, this is what I'm going to say. When all you have the money in your hands, you have tithed because you want to continue fighting greed and selfishness. God entrusts you. You know, hii 1,000 umepeana 100 as tithe. Sidio, umebaki na ngapi? 900. But now let me ask us the question. Ile 100, ile 1,000 yote ilikuwa ya nani? Ya Mungu. Sasa amekuitisha Justin, umepeana. So you are left with 900. When you now show God you are trustworthy, you are disciplined, you are honest, you are faithful, he now gives you ability and power and wisdom to manage the 900. But olewako, and this is out of experience, if you fail to give the 10, you lack the knowledge, the wisdom, the power to spend the whole 1,000, and it all goes to waste. It is management. God wants to see us, that ability, that willingness to actually set it aside for his kingdom. It is so important to him. God is not raising money. Wakati natuambia tulete tithe, hata wakati tutajitolea hapa, kile mtu wako nacho. God is not raising money. Hey, Mungu wako na fundraising. No. The art of giving is not God's means of raising money. It's God's means or program of raising children. God is raising good, knowledgeable children through the art of giving. Lastly, that is the principle of management. Na tumeona vitu kadhaa, so by tithing how it does, and I'm only laying a foundation, so I won't go into details. Now that you are faithful and you are diligent enough to set apart that which belongs to God, the last sharia, I mean the last law or principle, is the principle of abundance. Now the principle of abundance, ndio hii sasa watu wana confuse na gospel of prosperity. Because the law of abundance, it is what the Bible in 2 Corinthians, here hatutasoma, I'll just mention 2 Corinthians 9:6. The Bible says, whoever sows, 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 6 to 15, the Bible says of, ukipanda kidogo, utavuna kidogo. So, it now depends on how you manage what you have in your hands. Ukitaka kupanda sana, utavuna sana. That is a law that God said. And then, Luke chapter 6, verse 38, Luke 6, 38 is where the Bible talks of, ukipeana, God will make people to give to you, yeah, and up to overflow, or bountiful, up to overflow. That is the law of abundance. Now that comes last. Do you know now, these are my last statements, and I'm going to tell us this. Of the three principles, or three laws of giving, the law of sufficiency or contentment, the law of management, and the law of abundance, Yesu kwa maisha yake, wale watu tunajua maisha ya Yesu kuligana vile imeandikwa. Though he taught them, he concentrated so much to teach the first principle and the second one. And that's why Jesus never lived in overflow. Jesus never lived in overflow. Hakuna wakati yeti alipata chakula nyingi alafu akakosa pa kuweka. Though he thought that we are able to plant and we have more. Iyo ni ile gospel sasa ya prosperity. Wekelea, wekelea. Jesus knew what will guide you to have abundance na ishike mikono is understanding of the first two principles. The law of contentment, so that you can never kill anybody or you can never steal from anybody to have abundance. You can never think of bribing God to have abundance. First of all, understand the first two principles. Ah, watu wengine wengi unasikia kwenye nchi hii. Kama sahihi watu wengine, kuna amenipigia simu dogo yangu akaniuliza siku ya jana. Kama hey, kuna watu wachache sana town. Kama bia labda unajua sio watu wote wanakuja kazi, wengine wameshafutwa. Haya. Wengine wamefutwa kazi na serikali. The ministers. Sorry for that. This is what I'm saying. Those people, some of them went there wakiwa na pesa nyingi sana. Ile wali declare that is their wealth. But unfortunately, wengine wao, they have become overly corrupt. Because, someone went there with 1 billion shillings. And then SCADOS, bado sahi ziko, and they are being mentioned with other SCADOS. Those people, they are misinterpreting abundance. If only they learned the art of contentment, that person, you are richer than him if you are contented in your heart. If you're able to thank God and to worship him with what you have, other than them. So the issue is not having so much, because actually it's only God who knows how much you'll have before you go to the grave. It's only God. And even those that are having so much, they're actually leaving them. Thank God for us, who knows the greatest thing that we should do in this world is to worship God with our hearts. So, usidaganyike kukibiria abundance before you learn and you train your heart on management, you avoid wastage and sufficiency. You are content. Your heart is not grumbling. And that is why the children of Israel, they were killed as many as possible in the desert because of kunugunika, murmuring. And Philippians 2 also tells us we should not murmur or grumble. It is because the heart is not content. The heart is not content. Imagine in the Old Testament, wakiraramika hivi, God was killing them. What a lesson. A grumbling heart is a heart that is not contented. Mimi sijasema watu tusipoke pesa, tutapokea nyingi. I only pray this prayer before the Almighty God, that God will give you abundance after he has trained you on the law, on the principle of sufficiency or contentment and proper management. There is one singer mwenye aliiba na akasema, na nilishukuru sana kwa hiyo ka statement, kamekuwa kakijirudia kwangu. Gaiduka hebesha, agekoro ukuhe onyime, uge wago shihodhira, kafasikare. Mungu kama utanipa hela, na uninyime hekima ya kuzitumia, management, afadhali zikai, because they put us to the grave. And God, you call us very poor people. Nimemaliza, na ninashukuru Mungu kwa hiyo nafasi. Let us pray. Can you seek God to help you to... If you have learned something, anything, I'm not going to tell us what to pray about. But me, I really would pray that God will help me to not being selfish, not to be greedy, and to learn to worship God with my heart. Through a contented heart is what God is asking me to worship him with. That my heart will be contented, and that I will learn the wisdom of managing what God has given me. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, thank you for us. You have given us grace to listen to your word, and I pray that as we appropriate it, it will be with us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen. The Lord bless us so much. Thank you for being attentive. I'm now going to ask Pastor Karori to come and lead us to give.